Hey guys, Miss Steele here. So, gonna do, continue on with Mr. Popper's Penguins. I didn't realize it's been quite a while since I had continued reading with this. So we left off at chapter 6. In chapter 6, the police officer showed up at the house and they were like, what's going on here? He wanted to know what that was in the house, only to realize it was a penguin. And then he had Mr. Popper call City Hall and try and figure out, like, if he needed a special license, if he needed a permit, what he needed to do. And no one at City Hall could understand him, could answer his questions. No one seemed to have any idea. So he got really frustrated with them and hung up the phone. So, chapter 7, Captain Cook built a nest. Very reluctantly, Janie and Bill had to leave Captain Cook to go to school. Mrs. Popper was busy in the kitchen rather belatedly doing the breakfast dishes. And while she dimly realized that the penguin was going in and out of the refrigerator pretty frequently, she thought nothing of it at first. Meanwhile, Mr. Popper had abandoned his telephoning and was now busy shaving and making himself neat in honor of being the owner of such a splendid bird as Captain Cook. But the penguin, though thus neglected for the moment, was by no means idle. With the unusual excitement and having to go to the market earlier than usual, Mrs. Popper had not yet got around to straightening the house up. She was an excellent housekeeper. Still, with two children like Janie and Bill and a husband with such untidy ways, there is no denying the fact that she had to pick up the place rather frequently. Captain Cook was now attending to the picking up. Into the corners of every room, he prowled and poked and pecked with a busy thoroughness. Into every closet, he stared with his white circled eyes. Under and behind all the furniture, he crowded his plump figure with little subdued cries of curiosity, surprise, and pleasure. And each time he found what he seemed to be looking for, he picked it up in the black end of his red beak and carried it waddling proudly on his wide pink feet into the kitchen and into the icebox. At last, it had occurred to Mrs. Popper to wonder what on earth the busy bird was up to. When she looked, she could only scream to Mr. Popper to come quickly and see what Captain Cook had done now. Mr. Popper himself, looking rather remarkable, as Mrs. Popper noticed later, joined her in staring with astonishment into the refrigerator. Captain Cook came up too and helped them look. "Ork, ork," he said with triumph. Mrs. Popper laughed and Mr. Popper gasped as they saw the result of Captain Cook's trips through the house. Two spools of thread, one white chess bishop, and six parts of a jigsaw puzzle, a teaspoon and a closed box of safety matches, a radish, two pennies, a nickel, and a golf ball, two pencil stubs, one bent playing card, and a small ashtray, five hairpins, an olive, two dominoes, and a sock, a nail file, four buttons of various sizes, a telephone slung, seven marbles, and a tiny doll's chair, five checker pieces, a bit of graham cracker, and a cup, and an eraser, a door key, a button hook, and a crumpled piece of tinfoil, half of a very old lemon, the head of a china doll, Mr. Popper's pipe, and a ginger ale cap, an ink bottle cork, two screws and a belt buckle, six beads from a child's necklace, five building blocks, a darning egg, a bone, a small harmonica, and a partly consumed lollipop, two toothpaste lids, and a small red notebook. I guess this is what we call the rookery, said Mr. Popper, only he couldn't find any stones to build his nest with. Well, said Mrs. Popper, those penguins may have heathen ways at the South Pole, but I declare I think this is going to be quite helpful around the house. Or, said Captain Cook, and struggling into the living room, he knocked over the best lamp. I think, Papa, said Mrs. Popper, that you had better take Captain Cook outside for a little exercise. Good gracious, but you're all dressed up. Why, you look almost like a penguin yourself. Mr. Popper had smothered down his hair and shaved off his whiskers. Never again would Mrs. Popper have to reproach him for looking as wild as a lion. He had put on a white shirt with a white tie and white flannel trousers and a pair of bright tan oxblood shoes. He had got out of the old cedar chest his old black evening coat. Then he had that he had been married in and brushed it carefully and put it on too. He did indeed look a little like a penguin. He turned and strutted like one now, Mrs. Popper. But he did not forget his duty to Captain Cook. "Can I have a few yards of clothesline, please, Mama?" asked Papa. Well, that's it for Chapter 7. So in Chapter 7, all that really happened was Captain Cook is helping clean up around the house and putting all this stuff that he's finding throughout the house, all kinds of random things. He's putting every single thing in the fridge. And Mrs. Popper's like, this could be good. He's helping us clean up. I kind of like it. So we'll have to see what happens in Chapter 8.